The objective is not to teach you how to send a model in a view bag. The objective is to have another practice on view bag. And we shall demonstrate how you can use the view bag to send a model to the view. Don't do this in practice. This is wrong programming. But just for your curiosity and just for the academic interest, I'll show how this is done, because it is better to always pass the model, because if you try to send a model in a view bag, you are violating the whole programming concept here. So let me come straight to the coding part. This is a basic MVC application that we have created using the basic template, and we shall now first of all create a model object. Right click on the models folder, add class, and call it cStudentData. And here I'll give a property called public string name getSet. Don't forget this getSet, because it will work without getSet. You might be tempted to remove this getSet, but at certain places in MVC, this getSet is built in, it is required, and you won't be able to find bugs in case you forget this small thing. So make it your religion. Do it always religiously. Okay. Public string roll number get set. So we have created two properties on cStudentData, and here we'll create an object of cStudentData. I'll have to resolve it because I put it inside the models folder. Resolve using model. So basically this line has been added here. cStudentData CST is equal to new cStudentData CSD dot. It's better to use straightway. Name is equal to Hovan. Roll number is equal to my roll number. I've created an object of cStudentData. The right approach is to simply write CSD here, but just for academic interest, view bag dot my model is equal to CSD. You don't have to pass anything to the view, because you're creating a dynamic property on view bag and storing CSD into it. View bag dot gas name is equal to I'm passing a string O sub 3, so this is subscript. So it should display like this. So I've created two dynamics. One is a model and the other is gas name. And we shall now go to our view to collect them there. First of all, we'll display our cStudentData. We can write student name is equal to @ view bag dot. Look, no IntelliSense. So it's always error prone. Paste dot name. Even this is totally error prone. I have to rely very heavily on accuracy of typing. Gas is equal to view back dot gas name. Everything here is likely to appear correctly except for the last one, which I deliberately added because it is containing HTML here. Whereas generally we haven't passed HTML directly into a property, but here I deliberately added a property that will receive HTML, and our target would be to display that HTML correctly on the screen. Let us run it and see what we get for the present. So this is what we get on the screen. Student name is Hovan, picked correctly. Student roll number is my roll number, picked correctly. But gas is appearing in English form, in HTML form, which is not what we want. Let us view source. What has happened? It has been HTML encoded here. It's written 0 and LT sub and GT. So it has been HTML encoded. What we want is that instead of HTML encoding, it should go as proper HTML. So here we have a function available, @HTML.raw. Now whatever HTML you pass into this, that will go as HTML and will be presented in the proper format on the browser. This is what I want to actually tell you here. @HTML.raw can be used to display HTML by bringing it from the action and displaying it correctly on the view. @HTML.raw. Run it. This time it comes correctly with the proper subscript. You can take up a small exercise. Use HTML.raw to display 1 square plus 2 square is equal to 5. The HTML for this one should be passed through viewback. So as a hint, I can tell you that it will be something like this: 1 sup 2 sup closed plus etc. So this can serve as a hint to you. You'll pass the entire HTML string through viewback and display it on the screen using HTML.raw. We'll close it right now. Thanks.